Rape is often used as a weapon of war, and it was used by ISIS against Yazidi women on an industrial scale. That's why Nobel Prize laureate and Yazidi rape survivor Nadia Murad urged the United Nations to take action ahead of their vote on measures against rape in war and conflict.
We had hoped that telling our stories would be the door through which ISIS members would be brought to justice. But today, thousands of them enjoy freedom, and thousands others are in jail without a trial. What we are calling for today is to bring the perpetrators of genocide to justice.
The resolution should have been a straightforward reaffirmation of resolutions already made in 2013 and 2009. But a threat of a veto from the United States made the UN remove a key phrase: the need for rape survivors in conflict zones like this one to have access to sexual and reproductive health, in other words, abortions. It's a move that the French ambassador condemned.
Il est intolérable et incompréhensible.
It is intolerable and incomprehensible that the Security Council is incapable of acknowledging that women and girls who have suffered sexual violence in conflict and who obviously didn't choose to become pregnant should have the right to terminate their pregnancy.
The resolution was passed, though Russia and China abstained. This is the latest of several attempts by the US to remove references to abortions in UN resolutions.